Wicked, so workout number two. Hope you enjoyed the first one. So like I said, everything's gonna be different each time I do it. Don't do the same thing because it gets a little bit boring. So same as usual, I'll warm you up, I'll warm up a little bit differently, same thing. Don't do the same thing, it's just boring. So this time we'll start with walkout. So feet nice and flat, walk forward as far as you can, then walk your hands all the way back up, walk all the way forward, and then walk all the way back up. Just gonna go five of them. Last one. And then from there, you can try to get your feet all the way up to your hands. Just gonna go eight there. Four on each side, have a little stretch. Two more. One more. And then from there, walk your feet up to your hands. As soon as they're tight, start walking them back. Straight back up. We're gonna go five of these. As I said, just fly through it. Try and get as warm as quick as you can. And then one more. And then walk your hands all the way up. From there, five lunges with a twist. Forward, twist over your knee, back up, five on each leg. Ooh. And then straight up side, let's see feet, knee to the floor, twist over, back up. Keep going. One more. And then from there, just gonna do the reverse. Gonna go four on each leg. Once you have four on the left, go straight to four on the right. And then from there, gonna rock onto your back. We're gonna go 10 single leg glute bridges on each leg, straight to 10 dead bugs. So right leg, left leg up, 10, let's go, one. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Switch to the other side, let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. From there, legs gonna come up, hands gonna come up in the air, opposite hand. Opposite foot, tense your stomach up as hard as you can, keep that back on the flat. Going 10 again, 5 on each side. Fully open up your arms and legs, come back in, go again. Hold time, try to brace up as hard as you can. Take your time. One more, and then from there, I'm gonna go straight back to glute bridges this time. Both feet, just gonna go 15, go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Flip over, going straight into 16 shoulder taps. Just take your time, brace up, body shouldn't move. Go, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. One more and relax. Right, from there, grab a kettlebell, any, doesn't make any difference. Just gonna warm you up, we're gonna go 40 seconds, jump over, jump on, jump over, jump on, jump over, jump on, right? So literally from here, just jump over, turn around, jump over, turn around. Literally just gonna go 4 seconds, just get your legs a little bit warmed up. So go in, three, two, one, off you go. So jump over, turn around, jump over, turn around, jump over. Halfway. Seconds. Just take time, just literally just get your legs nice and warm. 3, 2, 1, and relax. From there, I'm just going to go straight into 20 seconds of mountain climbers. So again, just getting your legs nice and warm. So, 20 seconds, going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, off. We go. So literally just take time, just get your knees all at your chest. Ten seconds. Three, two, one, and relax. Cool, right, so from there we're gonna go to number one. So again, pick a weight. You can do a goblet squat. It's up to you how heavy you want to go. We're going to go straight into 20 seconds of goblet squat, straight into 10 seconds of squat jump. So it'll be 30 seconds altogether. Just going to go 2 rounds. So 20 seconds goblet squat. When I say switch, just pop on the floor, go straight into 10 seconds of squat jumps. Just 2 rounds, a 10 second break between each round. Just gonna fly straight through it. So, 20 seconds of goblet squats. Going in, 3, 2, 1, go. So I said, open up the hips, keep the feet nice and flat. Just going 20 seconds. Ten seconds to go. Five, four, three, two, one. 10 seconds, off you go. Five, four, three, two, one. That's 1 round done. 10 second break, just going straight back in, exactly the same thing. Round two, going in, 3, 2, 1, go. 20 seconds. 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 seconds, off you go. 3 Then from there, we're going to go for a 3 minute flow. So basically, don't worry about how many rounds you do in the 3 minutes. It's just basically making sure that you last the 3 minutes and back put it on the floor. So there'll be a couple of exercises. You'll remember the exercises. Once you've done it, you'll go to the middle, you'll switch, and then go to the opposite side. So for example, it's going to be 5 swings. Right, you're going to start on your right hand side. Once you've done 5 swings, you're going to pop it up. 2 presses, 1 front squat, 1 overhead lunge. Then you'll switch it. Best way of switching it is have it in this position. Fingertips, push it away, through, switch, and then you're straight into the opposite side. So 5 swings, 2 presses, 1 front squat, 1 overhead lunge, switch. 3 minutes, going in. 3, 2, 1, off we go. So 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Get into the front wrap position. Boom. Right. 2. Go. 1, 2. Front squat. Pop it back up. Overhead lunge. Bombs. Bring it back to the middle. Push. Switch. Off you go. 5, 1, 2, 2.5. Let's go. 3, 4, 5. Into that front wrap position. If it's heavy, push press it. One front squat, pop it back up, overhead reverse lunge, bring it back to the middle, push it away, straight in, five, one, two, three, four, five, get it up. From there, press twice, front squat, pop it back up, just take your time, there's no rush on these, bring it to the middle, push away, just try and last 3 minutes. As I said, it gets heavy, push press it, or drop down if you really need to. Switch. 1 minute 20 to go. Stay loose in your fingers. Minute to go. Can you get one more in? Five to go. Five to go. Seconds to go. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab yourself a drink. Wicked. So, grab yourself a quick drink, and then I want you to grab the kettlebell that you're going to use for kettlebell swings. Cool, so we're gonna go Tabata style, which is 8 rounds, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds rest, right? So first round's gonna be a heavy kettlebell swing, second round will be alternating swing, third round you can choose between normal swing again or American swing where it goes above your head, and then round four will be figure of eight, and then obviously you repeat that again, that's 8 rounds. So round one, heavy swing. Round two, alternating swing. Round three, American swing or normal kettlebell swing. And then round four, the one where it goes in and out of your legs. So like I said, rest time's gonna be really, really short. So like I said, don't get too comfortable. Round one, 20 seconds, good. In, 8 rounds, and three, two, one, off we go. Ten seconds. Three, two, one. Right, 10 seconds rest, and then we're straight back in, alternating swing. Go, three, two, one, go. 15. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 seconds rest. So if you need to, drop down for the American swing because it goes above your head, or stay with normal swings. Round three, go in three, two, one, off we go. Fifteen. Ten. So I said, if you're doing these ones, make sure you drive your head all the way through, stay tight in your arms. 5, 4, 3, 2, One, right? 10 second rest. Round four, we're halfway through. Figure of eight. Free your leg, squeeze your bum, catch it. Going in. 3, 2, 1, off we go. 15. Same as kettlebell swing. Hips go back, squeeze your bum, catch it in your original shoulder. 10 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. 10 seconds rest, go back to the start. This will be round five, doing 8 rounds. Woo! Get in. 3, 2, 1, off we go, normal swing. Stay nice and tight. All come through your hips, arms stay tight. Five, four, three, two, one. 10 seconds rest, alternating swing. Round six, going in. 3, 2, 1, off. We go. So say it again, try and get into that chest height, use your hip. Five, four, three, two, one. Drop down if you need to. American swings or normal swings again. Whew. Round seven, two to go. And 3, 2, 1, off we go. Drive that head through. Same as usual. Squeeze your bum. 15. Ten. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Round eight. Last round. Figure of eight. Round eight, going in. 3, 2, 1. So it always goes back to your original shoulder. Squeeze your bum, make sure you fully stand tall. 15. 10 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. Grab yourself a drink. Whew. So for the next bit, we're going upper body, we're going clean and press and shoulder press. So we're gonna start with shoulder press. Shoulder press first, that's obviously gonna be your heaviest. And then we go straight to clean and press. So we'll go 1 minute on each arm. So strict press, if it's heavy, push press. After 30 seconds, drop straight into clean and press, no rest. Then we get a 15 second rest, obviously go onto the opposite side. So first 30 seconds, strict press, push press. Second 30 seconds, clean and press. 1 minute, go in. 3, 2, 1. Off we go. So strict press for 30 seconds. If it's heavy, push press. If it's really heavy, flick to this one. Exactly the same thing. You got just over 15 seconds to go, and then we straight swap. 10 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one, clean and press, off you go. Use your legs, think straight up. Imagine you're stood in front of a wall. 20 to go. If it's tired, take a few seconds, go back in. Ten to go. Five, four, three, two, one. Take a 15 second break. Straight to opposite arm. So I said, if it is too heavy, switch to this. Much easier. Five, four, three, two, one. Off we go. Strict press. Nice and tight. Push press, dip, bounce if it gets heavy. You're just under 20 to go. Five, four, three, two, one. Clean the press, no break. Doesn't have to touch the floor. As soon as you feel your legs, get it back up. 20 to go. Just over 10. Stay nice and tight, drive the heels to the ground. Five, four, three, two, one. Grab yourself a drink. Woo! So for the next one, you need two kettlebells, one that you're gonna row and one that you're not gonna row. So obviously, push one hand into the one you're not using, the one you are using, you're gonna row, right? So we're gonna go two rounds, but obviously two on each side. So first round, you're gonna go for a 20-second hold, sorry, a 10-second hold into 20 seconds a row, swap over to the other side. The next one, we're gonna break it up. You'll do 6 reps, 6-second hold, repeat that 3 times on each arm. I'll talk you through it, you'll be fine. So, get into position, so make sure you're straight back. If you feel anything in your legs, you're doing too much of a squat. So, hinge, from here, reach down. If you feel like you're too much over it, sit back a little bit, knees out. 10 second hold in 3, 2, 1, hold. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 20 seconds, row, go. 15. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 second break, straight to the other side. Exactly same thing, 10 second hold, 20 seconds roll. Going in, 3, 2, 1, flat back and hold. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 20 seconds, go. Three, two, one, relax. Take a 15 second break, straight back to the first side. So now you're gonna do 6 reps, 6 second hold. 6 reps, 6 second hold, 6 reps, 6 second hold. So 3 times on each arm, and then we swap over sides. Going in, 3, 2, 1, go. 6 reps, 1, 2, 3, 4, five, now hold. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 6 reps, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hold. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, now hold. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 seconds rest. If you find that too heavy, just drop down to your next one, or don't hold it for so long. Good, here, 3, 2, 1, 6 reps, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hold. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, now hold. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. 6, 1, two, three, four, five, hold, six, five, four, three, two, one, and relax. Grab yourself a drink. Cool, right, so next one. Pick a weight that you can press above your head. That's obviously not gonna have to bounce, right? Because you don't want it to go too heavy. So, say we're gonna go for a minute on each leg, right? So, from here, you're gonna have it in a front wrap position. If it is really uncomfortable and you really hate doing this position, you can just do it down here, and we're just gonna have to change yours kind of up. All right, so if you're doing the normal one, you're gonna go forward lunge, let your knee hit the floor, press. Stand up, straight into reverse lunge, right? Stand up, repeat that again. If you don't like holding in this position, you're then gonna hold it by your side. You'll do a reverse lunge, come up, press, bring it down, reverse lunge, press. You'll do it a little bit differently, right? So 1 minute, forward lunge, kneeling press, stand up, reverse lunge, repeat it all over again. 1 minute, going in. Three, two, one, off you go. So forward lunge, knee hits the floor, press up, bring it down, stand up, reverse lunge, back to the middle, forward lunge, press, stand up, reverse lunge, repeat. Halfway through on this one already. Seconds to go. Just over 10 seconds to go. Five seconds. Three, two, one. 15 second break, straight to the opposite side. So like I said, if you're not doing the normal one, then your reverse lunge, pick it up, press, go back down, reverse lunge. Go again, opposite side, in. Three, two, one, off we go. Let your knees softly touch the floor, press, drive your foot back up, straight into reverse lunge. Go again. Four seconds to go. Halfway through. Fifteen seconds to go. 10 seconds to go. Five, four, three, two, one, grab yourself a drink. Woo. So, from there, you're gonna have the heaviest kettlebell you've got. We're going straight in for Romanian deadlift into normal deadlift. So we're gonna go 1 minute straight through. So, from here, right, Romanian deadlift. Soft knee, don't bend them, right? Little knee bend, and then from here, sit your hips back. As soon as it's tight your hamstrings, squeeze your bum, drive through, right? You're gonna do that for 30 seconds. Then when I say switch, straight into normal deadlift, which is like a deadlift into kind of like a squat, right? So two exercises combined together, 30 seconds on each. Go in. Three, two, one, off you go. So soft knee, sit the hips back. As soon as it's tight your hamstrings, squeeze your bum, drive them together. Fifteen seconds gone. Five, four, three, two, one. Switch, go. 30 seconds, deadlift. Drive the floor away, drive knees, straight up, straight down. Your kettlebell's not heavy, alternate your hands. 10 seconds. Stay nice and tight. Think head to the top ceiling, drive your feet, drive your knees. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And relax. So next bit, we're gonna go single leg RDL. So don't go too heavy. We're gonna go 1 minute on left side, 1 minute on your right side, so you get enough reps in. So there's two ways you can do it. One way is you start with it on the floor. From here, you pick it up, you gently put it back down, let your hand go away, that'd be one. Or you keep it up the whole entire time. As soon as you feel in your hamstring, drive straight through. So it's never gonna hit the floor, right? Don't try and hit the floor if you're doing that one. The objective is to stick, keep your whole balance the whole entire time. So I said, don't go too heavy. You can put one hand on the wall, it needs some support. So, 1 minute, left hand side, leg going up in the air in 3, 2, 1. So soft knee, imagine trying to kick someone. Get it, drive foot, come through. Take your time, don't care about reps. As soon as you feel it, turn your hamstring, squeeze bone, drive that leg in. Like I said, if you're doing the other one, you softly put it on the floor, hand comes through, restart it all over again. Halfway through. So nice and slow, pop it down, drive through. 20 seconds to go. Just stay nice and tight, keep that big toe and heel driven into the ground the whole time. To start it, keep your body straight, kick your leg back, and then hinge. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 seconds rest, straight to your side. So I said, best way of doing it is soft knee, kick that leg back first, and then start to hinge. You don't want to feel like you're trying to tuck under and pick it up. So, opposite side. Going in, 3, 2, 1, off we go. One leg will always be better than the other. Like I said, you don't want it to crash off the floor if you're doing it this way. If you're doing it the other way, like I said, just go to the point where you're feeling your hamstring and then you can come back up. 45 to go. So you should be feeling this in your left butt cheek and your left hamstring. If you're feeling your lower back, then you're trying too hard to kind of tuck over it. 20 to go. 15 to go. 10 seconds to go. 3, 2, 1, and relax. Grab yourself a drink. So right, we're just gonna do a little bit of abs before we go on to the next bit, which will actually be the finish of today. So we're gonna go 1 minute of windmills, right? There's two ways you can do it. So you're gonna set your feet up, one facing forward, one facing the wall, right? Legs straight. From here, you're gonna click your hip into place. You'll feel it go into place. Keep these reasonably straight. One hand goes up in the air and you're gonna stare at it. The other hand inside of your leg. From here, all you do is stare at that hand, keeping your hip back. As soon as you tighten your hamstring, squeeze your bum, come all the way up. Easy version. Kettlebell stays here. You stare at your hand, keep that hip back, squeeze your bum, drive up. That's the easy version. Hardest version, you do it from the top. Like I said, click that hip in, legs nice and straight, feel your hand go down your leg, as soon as you tighten your hamstring, drive up, right? You're gonna feel a lot in your hamstring and you're gonna feel a lot in here. If you feel anything in your lower back, that's bad. If you feel something here, that's absolutely fine. Don't panic. Okay, so go light. Just go light. And like I said, if it's too heavy at the top, just stay at the bottom, right? 1 minute on each side. Go in, 3, 2, 1, off we go. So hip in place, legs in the usually just straight. Stare at that kettlebell. Squeeze it tight, squeeze bum, stand up, reset. Hip go back. We got 40 seconds to go. Take your time, hip back, legs reasonably quite straight. Let your hand slide down your leg. Keep staring at that fish. Don't look at anything else. I'll tell you the time. 20 seconds to go. Ten seconds to go. If you're not confident at the top, go to the bottom. 3, 2, 1, 15 seconds rest. So like I said, you're doing it from the bottom, same position, hip, stare at that hand, same again. You stand up, lay on the floor, stand up, right? So opposite side, going in. 3, 2, 1, off we go. Just get that arm nice and locked. Keep staring at it, keep that hip back, click into place, and then go. Make sure you fully stand up. Like I said, if it gets heavy, drop it down to the floor, do it from the floor. Makes it a little bit easier. You're gonna feel it in the side of your back, that's fine. Halfway to go. Seconds go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab yourself a drink and then I'll break down the last bit of the workout. So, today, finish your wide. We're going 4 times. I'm going to put a 10-minute time cap on it, so you're going to see how far you can get in 10 minutes. If you finish it before 10 minutes, fantastic. If you don't, it's not the end of the world. Same again, you just do this workout again, like a month down the line, and see if you beat your score, and that's what I'm gonna tell you, you've got a little bit fitter. So, all I need you to do is possibly have 2 kettlebells, or maybe just 1, depending on how different weights you've got, right? So, you need 1 for the kettlebell swing. So ideally, try and go as heavy as you can. If your kettlebell's not that heavy, then do alternating swings instead, right? And then the other kettlebell you need is 1 for a thruster, which is a squat into a press. Same again, if you haven't got multiple kettlebells, that's fine, just use the same one, it's not the end of the world. If you've got dumbbells, you can use dumbbells. Same with swings, if you've got no kettlebells and using dumbbells, you can do goblet squat instead, it's not a problem, right? So, kettlebell swings, thrusters, prisoner squats, hands behind your head, all the way up, all the way down, and then normal push-ups or push-ups on your knees. So, it goes 20 reps of everything. Then 18 reps of everything, 16 reps of everything, all the way down to 2. And you're gonna see how far you can get down the ladder in 10 minutes. So grab your kettlebells. I would probably say put them in position so you can just literally slide to one or the other, all right? Or if you're using the same, it's not the end of the world. So 10 minute timer's going on. I give everyone a countdown and we're going straight in. So 10 minutes, let's see how far we can get. So, 10 second countdown. 20 swings, 20 thrusters, 20 prisoner squats, 20 push-ups. Then go 18, 16, 14, all the way down to 2. Go in 3, 2, 1, go. Try to get the kettlebells at chest high. That's 20 done for me. 20 thrusters, a squat into a press. Woo! 40 seconds gone. Make sure your bum breaks your knees. Make sure you fully extend your arms. Once on that, 20 prisoner squats, hands behind your head. Make sure your bum goes below your knees. Fully stand up.
20 push-ups, go on your knees if you need to. So now I've done that, I go down to 18. 8 minutes, 10 to go. Woo! 7:50. Seven 30 to go. Whew. Keep going. Woo, legs. 7 minutes, let's go. Four to go. Let's try and get to 12. Whew. 6, 10. So keep going. Just on the 6. Woo. Whoa. 5:45. Point. 5:10. Get up, kettlebells chest high. Under 5 minutes. Whoa. 4:20, let's go. Just keep powering on through. Ming in. 4 minutes. Well, 3:50. Yeah.
Free play.
Just keep on going.
Whoa.
Way, free Miska.
Free Mitch.
Keep on going. I said go on your knees, you need to.
Two feet.
Two, 15. Nearly there, keep going. Try and aim for 10. We're under 2 minutes.
One, 40 to go.
One, 10. Come up to the last minute.
Come on, let's try your last one done. 15.
So yeah, anyone complete that? Well done, that was odd. So yeah, that was workout number 2. Like I said, each day I'm gonna mix them up. You can do things with kettlebells and dumbbells. Obviously swings will just be a bit different. Then you can just change them up. As long as you work hard, you'll be fine. So, I hope you enjoyed that one. And I'll see you again this week. Bye!